everyone. Let's look at how you can interpret a simple quantile-quantile plot and how it's implemented from scratch in Pandas. So, let's get started. A QQ plot is a scatter plot created by plotting two sets of quantiles against one another. If both sets of quantiles came from the same distribution, we should see the points forming a line that's roughly straight. The procedure to draw QQ plot for all the above applications are the same. I'll explain the most common use of QQ plot, that is, to check if my sample data is from a normal distribution. Most of the parametric tools in statistics work with the assumption that the sample data is drawn from a normal distribution. So, in order to rely on the results of those tools, it is necessary to be confident about the sample data distribution. Let's start by reading the data from a CSV file after importing our necessary modules. I want to check if the points column in my data frame DF is normally distributed. The first thing that I'll do is, I'll arrange the points column data in ascending order. Next, I'll divide the standard normal distribution, that is the theoretical distribution, into n plus 1 equal parts, where n is the number of data points. For example, if we have, in our case, we have 44 data points, so we divide the standard normal distribution into 45 parts. Each region or each region will have the area of 0.0227. Okay. Let's check if this is true. So if I do df.head, I run the corresponding cell to calculate the percentile area, and this is what we get. So at every step, you have an increment of area of 0.0227, which is the theoretical percentile area. Now, the only thing that I have to do in terms of the theoretical value is find out the Z value for each region using the NDTRI package from the scipy.special package. Okay. So, what I do next is I calculate the theoretical value. Once the theoretical value is calculated, now I calculate the Z-scores by iterating over each row and subtracting it from the mean and dividing it with the standard deviation. Now that we have both theoretical and actual z-scores, we plot a scatter plot. Not all points fall on the y equal to x line. So this isn't completely normally distributed. Okay. However, just to check an entirely normal distribution, how would it look like? I plot a scatter plot of theoretical z-scores on both the axes, and this is what I get. I hope this helped all of you understand how you can implement a QQ plot from scratch using Python. Stay tuned for more such awesome videos. It would be really motivating if you could like my video and subscribe to my channel. Thank you so much for watching.